Hello everyone. So this is the summary of the poem The Anniversary by John Donne, and this is the text of the poem. So when the poem starts, the poet is saying that since the poet and his beloved first met each other, kings and all their favorites, and the glory of their honor, beauty and wit has now passed away. Okay. And even the sun itself, which measures time, makes time means which measures time, is now 1 year older. Is elder by year means is now 1 year older. Okay. And now he says, all other things to their destruction draw, that all other things are moving towards their decay. Okay. All other things are subjected to death and destruction. Only our love has no decay, but their love is not subjected to any death and destruction because their love is immortal. Okay. Neither tomorrow nor yesterday can affect their love. Okay. He means to say that their love was similar when they met with each other, even today and even in future, their love will remain constant and unchanging. Okay. So this no tomorrow has nor yesterday, running it never runs from us away, and their love is not running away from them. Okay. It is constant, it is unchanging, and it will remain so, you know, till eternity. Okay. And their love is eternal. Last everlasting day, what does it mean? That their love will remain same till the end. Okay. Come to the next line. Now the poet is saying that two graves must hide thine and my corpse. Corpse here means corpse. If one might, death were no divorce. And now he says that if one grave is going to cover both of their bodies after death, okay, then even death is not going to separate them. So he means to say that if they are going to lie in a single grave after death, then death will not bring separation between them. Death were no divorce. Okay. And now he says that it is the fate of the other princes as well. Obviously, everyone is subjected to death. Even, princes and kings are also subjected to death. Okay. And they also lived a princely life, you know, by enjoying their love. Okay, when they are alive. Okay, they will think like that when they will be dead, that they also lived a princely life by enjoying love, by enjoying their love for each other. Must leave at last in death these eyes and tears of fat with true oaths and with sweet salt tears. And now he says that when they will be dead, then their ears and eyes will also be dead. The ears which were nourished by the oaths and the promises which they made to each other, and their eyes which were nourished by the sweet bitter tears. Okay, and so his eyes and his, you know, ears will be dead at the time. Okay, now come to the next lines. But souls where nothing dwells but love then shall prove this, or love, or a love increased there above. And now he says that their souls, you know, possess a lot of love for each other. Okay. And he says that their love is constant and unchanging, and their love is going to increase in heaven. When they will go to heaven, their love is going to increase. Okay. This is what he is saying, that but souls where nothing dwells but love, that their souls are full of love. Okay. Then shall prove this, or love increased there above. And when they will go to heaven, then their love is going to increase more. When bodies to their graves, souls from their graves remove. Okay. What will happen after their death? Their bodies are going to sink into the grave, and then souls are going to leave their bodies and will reach to heaven. Okay. So their bodies will decay in their graves and their souls will reach to heaven. This is what he means to say. Come to the next line. And then we shall be thoroughly blessed. Now he says that in heaven they will be blessed. Okay. Because they will be enjoying the blessings of God, and nobody is going to separate them there. And their love will become eternal. But we know more than all the rest. Okay. And here upon earth we are kings, and none but we can be such kings, nor of such subjects be, who is so safe as we, where none can do treason to us, except one of us two. Now he means to say that here on earth also they were the kings, or you know, in enjoying their love. So the kind of life they lived by loving each other, that life can be compared to the life of kings. Okay, so that's why he says that they were kings in their love making. Okay, and their only subject was to feel love for each other. That was the only subject. Obviously, kings have a lot of subjects to deal with, but their subject when they were alive was only love. Who is so safe as we? Now he says that nobody is more safe than them when they are in heaven, where none can do treason to us, where nobody can rob them of anything, or nobody can, you know, cheat them. Okay. And now he says, except one of us too. So unless one of them turns faithless, okay, so they can cheat each other, but they cannot be cheated by anybody else. True and false fears, let us refrain. What does it mean? That they don't want to get scared of the other fears, okay, whether those fears are real and, you know, are fake, okay? So they don't fear from anything. True and false fears, let us avoid. Though they should avoid true and false fears. Let us love nobly and live and add again years and years unto years. Now he says that let us love. Okay. And now he's advising his beloved that we need to love nobly and keep adding year to year to our life. Okay. Until they are 60. And to write 3 score means until they are 60 years of age. And then they are going to celebrate their golden jubilee, and then they will realize that it is only the second year of their love. So what does it mean? That their love will always be same and unchanging, and it will remain constant. And here the poem ends.